this times of guns and knives. I travel in this world with nothing in my hands. If anyone comes to molest, and evil begins to dominate, God is my only shield. Faith is my guide. Honor is my wealth. Truth is my fortune. In Yaw-Yan is my weapon.
My name is Master Benigno Iken Caniga Jr. I'm the founder of the Yaw-Yan Ardigma Martial Arts Federation Incorporated. I was a member of the Philippine team. I was teaching for 25 years. We are promoting here the sports of Yaw-Yan martial arts. Arnes, pandigma is arnes. R is arnes. Digma is pandigma. Instead by using of stick, it is the using of your forearm and your leg as your weapon. Yaw-Yan or digma is more practical than other martial arts. Yaw-Yan is no kata movements, no synchronized kicks. The Yaw-Yan is more practical by using of punches, elbow, knee strike, kicks, palo, back piece, flying knee. The Yaw-Yan, we can fight within close range and long range. As a father of the Yaw-Yan Ardigma, not only to teach the martial arts, number one, is the discipline. And then, values about the Yaw-Yan. Huwag ko mag-teach nga to go on sa street, you go to fight. I'll emphasize sa ilang to learn the martial arts, then the discipline, and the sports.
For me, Yaw-Yan Ardigma is not just a martial arts, it's not just a discipline, but it's a way of life, it's a way of living. Yaw-Yan Ardigma helps me cope up with any stress in life and also deal with all the challenges in life.
Daghan nagbisyo sa una na wapa kong Yaw-Yan. Mga kagubot, mga nagbisyo nga manungga, bamusil. Kung dili tungod ni Master Ikin, wapa kong mausab, inani karon nga. Ang nagkaroon, pinutan.
Ang chicks, naabog yun na perminti, kaya naamtay kasing-kasing. Natural lang yun na ma-inlove ta. Bawal ang sex, pero konti lang.
Hindi ang feelings nga first fight na daaw lang.
Dili lang makakatun ka sa martial arts, kundi dili sa disiplina. Kay kami dari gud tanan gud kay usa gid mi ka team dili lang la, muuli ka sa inyo ha kun dili muari ka diri sa gym usa ka anak ka ni Master Iken itrit sa ganya ka anak dili lang ka fighter kun dili anak jud ganiya.
I work as a call center representative, so that's in a graveyard shift. So after my work in the mornings, I come here practice.
How do you balance that?
Well, I don't know, because I just love this. So after I work, even though it's tiring and I'm so sleepy, I come here, I practice with my friends. So I find it very refreshing for me.
Yaw-Yan nakatabang na to, discipline. Especially, ang Yaw-Yan nakatabang yun kay help me a lot sa akong work as a police officer. Inigdakop sa criminals.
Tabang sang Yaw-Yan is discipline and teaching and more on nakadisiplina dyan sa everything.
Nagamit na ba ni mo Yaw-Yan sa gawas?
No. Ako di ko hilig og manita gubot sa gawas, sa streets. So mag-careful ko anytime pag na yung mga bugoy, mapalayo dyan ko. I keep distance ko. Kung may mga bagsik, so palayo ako. Away from, avoid lang ko sa disgrasya.
I was a Yaw-Yan practitioner when I was 13 years old. I started it in 2003. Seeing all these young fighters doing what they're doing, and then it's really impressive. I'm very inspired, and I'm actually considering, you know, training again.
A new Yaw-Yan member is about to become a part of the Yaw-Yan family. In Yaw-Yan, a tradition which is called branding or sealing of the Yaw-Yan emblem is necessary to prove the commitment to the martial art and to the brotherhood. The person then undergo a series of hazing by his seniors. But after all that, he is welcomed by his fellow practitioners and then now becomes a true Yaw-Yan member.
That's a traditional Yaw-Yan sealing or tatak. Ang Yaw-Yan na siya gitawag na baptismal rites. This is called the baptismal rites. Tatakan siya sa dughan. Ang sa dughan, mauna siya ang sa mga junior. And then ang sa shoulder, ang mga senior. So, they are accepted as a Yaw-Yan, a member of Yaw-Yan. And then, siya na po, sa sunod, siya na po ang mo, like mo baptize sa another new member.
They come here for different reasons. Some to stay fit, some to relieve stress or learn self-defense, and some to start a new life. Regardless of their motivations, what they learn here far exceeds their expectations. They had anticipated learning how to kick, how to box, how to defend themselves. What they had now foreseen was love, discipline, respect, camaraderie, commitment, and brotherhood, all from inside this humble gym. At the end of the day, it's not only about how hard they can punch, how high they can kick, or how fast they can move. What matters most are the values they've learned, the friends they have made, and the brotherhood they have created. All this is due to one person who they call Master, who not only serves as their teacher, but also as their mentor and father. Fighters, disciples of this art, anticipate their return to the gym each day after the next, not only to learn one of the deadliest martial arts, but also to experience training and solidarity with those they consider family.